How will history remember me? I hope it's taller than I look on TV. I'm every bit of 6'2 and a half, baby. So Donald Trump isn't president anymore. But while his term is now over, the analysis of where he will rank among our best and, yes, worst presidents is just getting started. Quote, on several occasions, Trump has suggested that he expects to take his place in the list of former presidents aside Abraham Lincoln, presumably knocking George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, and all the others in the top rank down a tick. That's presidential historian Joseph Ellis writing in an op-ed for the Los Angeles Times in mid-January, and Ellis went on to say, quote, to put it politely, he needs to adjust his expectations. And then Ellis added this, quote, Donald Trump is quite likely to assume the title as the worst president in American history, end quote. Now, deciding how presidents rank against one another is admittedly a subjective matter, and it's usually done by people like Ellis, academics and authors who have devoted their professional lives to the study of the presidency, which may not be a group naturally inclined to be drawn to Trump's decidedly anti-intellectual approach to, well, everything. But those are the people who tend to rank the presidents. I don't make the rules. I wish I did. God, I wish I did. So let's look at a few of the more recent presidential rankings and see where Trump stood. In 2019, Siena College released its rankings, the results of the combined views of 157 presidential scholars who rated each of the 44 men who have been president. Grover Cleveland was president on two different occasions, people, on 20 different aspects of the job. Sidebar, the categories range from integrity to willingness to take risks to plain old luck. Okay, so in those overall rankings, Trump placed third to last behind only James Buchanan and Andrew Johnson. Quote, the serving president has entered the survey between 15th, Obama, and 23rd, George W. Bush, as scholars begin to observe their accomplishments, assess their abilities, and study their attributes, said Don Levy, who runs the Siena College polling operation by way of explanation. He added this, quote, this year, Donald Trump enters the survey at 42nd, and he's only ranked outside of the bottom five in two of the 20 categories that scholars use to assess the presidents, luck and willingness to take risks. On luck, Trump ranked 10th. On willingness to take risks, he was 25th. Remember, too, that this came out in early 2019, long before the world had ever heard of COVID-19. The arrival of the pandemic is very likely to drop Trump's luck score in future surveys. Now, the other major recent study of the best and not best presidents came in 2018 from two political science professors, one at the University of Houston, one at the Boise State University. It is known as the Presidents and Executive Politics Presidential Greatness Survey, good name, and this one polls 170 members of the American Political Science Association. In that survey, Trump ranked dead last, trailing Buchanan, William Henry Harrison, Franklin Pierce, and Andrew Johnson, respectively. If you break out the relative ideology of the panel, Trump fares little better. Among identified conservatives, Trump was ranked as the 40th best president. Buchanan was conservative's choice as the worst president. But among moderates and liberals in the survey, as you might guess, Trump was ranked dead last. Now that same group was asked who the next president on Mount Rushmore would be, which by the way is sort of a theoretical question because the Park Service says there's no room to add more faces on Mount Rushmore. Anyway, only two presidents got double digit votes. Franklin Roosevelt, 108, and Barack Obama, 12. Donald Trump got zero votes, which is going to be a tough pill to swallow for Trump, who, according to the New York Times, broached the possibility of adding his visage to Mount Rushmore with the governor of South Dakota, Kristi Noem. This from Noem is enlightening on that subject. Quote, he said, Kristi, come over here, shake my hand. Noem told the Sioux Falls Argus Leader about a meeting with Trump in the Oval Office, adding, I shook his hand and I said, Mr. President, you should come to South Dakota sometime. We have Mount Rushmore. And he goes, do you know it's my dream to have my face on Mount Rushmore? I started laughing. He wasn't laughing, so he was totally serious, end quote. Sidebar, Noem reportedly gave Trump a 4-foot replica of Mount Rushmore with his face on it. And no, I'm not kidding. Now, making historical judgments about a president in the middle of his term, or even immediately after his term ends, like Trump now, is a dicey business. Ulysses S. Grant was widely seen to be a failure in the immediate aftermath of his presidency, but has fared far better in the light of history. Grant's ranked 24th by CNN and 21st in the Presidential Greatness Survey. Same goes for George H.W. Bush, 21st in Siena and 17th in the Presidential Greatness Survey. But at least at first glance, it seems unlikely that time is going to benefit Trump. After all, what these presidential rankings missed is the second half of Trump's term in office, which was dominated by his administration's botched handling of the coronavirus pandemic, his tone-deaf response to the Black Lives Matter protests in the summer of 2020, and his fact-free allegations of a rigged 2020 election, none of which is going to age well. Not to mention the fact that Trump made history as the only president to be impeached twice. Yeah, twice. Quote, I suspect the tour guides at Buchanan's National Historic Landmark home place, Wheatland, in Pennsylvania, are already celebrating, concluded Ellis in that op-ed, adding, their man, they must fondly hope, will never be last again. And that is The Point. We make new Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Be sure to check them all out.